Why should you save money? Hi everyone, I'm Jackie and we are enjoying life's journey on the path to financial freedom. Welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk about three reasons to save money. Last video I made, I talked about saving for emergencies. What are some of the other reasons? So I'll tell you what the three reasons are real quick and then we'll just go into a little more detail. So the first reason would be to save money for bigger purchases. So in order for you to stay out of debt and not to accumulate any more debt using a credit card or taking out a loan is to actually save up for those purchases ahead of time. The second reason is to save for emergencies, things that may have crept up that we just were not prepared for. And the third reason to save is for your future, for your retirement, for your legacy, for your children's future, things like that. So let's talk about the first one. First one, saving for purchases, okay? So a lot of people, you may have heard the term of sinking funds. And basically what that means is when you decide you wanna save for a specific purchase, you can set up a sinking fund, which basically just means a separate savings account for that amount. And the idea behind that to save what you want is you would take what it was that you wanted to purchase. So we're just gonna use some easy numbers here for example purposes, but let's say that I knew in 5 years from now that I needed to replace my vehicle, okay? And say I wanted to save $5,000 by that 5 years. So I would just divide, okay, that $5,000 divided by the 5 years would be $1,000 a year. So I need to save, you know, $1,000 every year in order to reach that goal. So I could basically divide that $1,000 into monthly payments if I wanted to do that. So I'd basically be saving, say, $83 a month for 5 years and I'd reach my $5,000. Or if I wanted to reach it sooner, then I would just do the math and I would reach it sooner. So say I wanted to do, you know, 2 years, then I would change the number that way. So it's kind of the idea behind a sinking fund is you take what you want and you divide it between the time frame that you want to have it by and you put it in a separate account. Now, I don't necessarily always use sinking funds in that way. I do set kind of a goal amount that I want to have and I do kind of set a time frame, but I don't necessarily put money the same amount in every month. It kind of just depends on how it is. So that, you know, you can kind of do that on your own. So that would be one thing, like I said, saving up for purchase. So again, things, like I said, it could be a car, it could be an upcoming vacation, it could be a new couch, it could be for your education, so you have to pay a semester for school, things like that. So the second one is your emergency fund. So I did a whole video on baby step three, which is saving your emergency fund. Dave Ramsey's baby step three, saving emergency fund. But in there, just real quick, how much do you need for an emergency fund? This is going to be dependent on everyone's personal situation. So a rule of thumb is to have a certain amount of months of your living expenses put aside, whatever you feel comfortable with. Is that 3 months of expenses, 6 months, 1 year? But like I said, this number can change for everybody because your living expenses could be different than somebody else's. So your living expenses are basically going to consider the things that you need to survive, your necessities. So if you were to lose a job, that you would make sure that you still had food on the table, a roof over your head, a transportation, and that. So if you are following Dave Ramsey's steps, hopefully you don't have any debt payments. But if you had debt payments that you were really concerned about losing, whatever was on the other end of that debt payment, like if you had a car payment and you're really concerned about losing that car payment, you might want to include that as part of your necessity bills as well. So whatever your number is, say your monthly expenses are $1,000 and you want 3 months put aside, you would want to save $3,000. If you wanted 6 months worth of an emergency fund, then you'd save $6,000. So again, that's basically the second reason to save is for emergencies. So you want to have that put aside. The third reason is to invest in your future, so you could either invest through your work, through pre-tax investment, which are your 401ks or your IRAs. You could do after-tax investments, which are like Roth IRAs. Within those, then you can invest in different mutual funds, or you could invest in individual stocks and bonds and things like that. You could also invest in real estate. You could decide that you want to have some rental properties. For myself, the idea of investing in my future is to have things that are going to bring me passive income later. So when I retire, I don't necessarily want just a big lump sum of money to live off of and actually spend. I want things that are going to continue to generate income so that I can leave money to my children, leave a legacy, and leave something like that. but that would be up to you. Again, depending on your lifestyle, it's going to determine how much money do you need at retirement. Do you, you know, if you want to live the same lifestyle you have, or if you want to live a better lifestyle than you have, then you're going to have to figure out some numbers to figure out how much do you actually need for retirement. I've done a video on the different stages of financial freedom, so I would recommend checking out that video. I talk about what the differences are in each one, and you can kind of go over and decide, okay, which area would you want to be in. There's great books out there, resources where people will kind of help you figure out the math behind it. So for us, if we want to be financially secure in order to live off of that income or to live off of that money when we retire, that would just basically pay for our necessities. We would need about $350,000 put aside by the time we retire. If we want to live financially free and live the current lifestyle we're living and actually live a little bit better of a lifestyle, then we're going to need about $700,000 invested somewhere that is generating some type of cash flow for us to live off of, basically including Social Security, if Social Security is still around by the time you retire. So I'm not going to go into all the details of that, but basically those are the three reasons you want to save, or what you'd be saving for. The first one, saving for actual purchases so you're not getting into debt. The second one is saving for emergencies. And the third one is saving for your future, investing for your retirement. I hope this helps you guys in some way. If you have some questions, go ahead and leave them below. As always, thanks for watching, and I will see you soon. Bye.